So, I suppose, Andy, who is one of the other, there's three of us basically, myself, Andy and Ed. Andy was a musician, he had a band called Groove Armada, which you may have heard of, and he was coming home from a gig about 15 years ago, and he read an article saying if we didn't radically change the food system, we were all finished, basically. And he was like, that's not great, I've got two little kids, I might want to do something about that. And he was coming to the end of his kind of natural touring life, he'd been on the road for a long time, and he started off by going, wanting to go kind of self-sustainable for him and his family, and then he got his hands in the soil. I don't know if you've ever grown anything that you've ended up eating, but it's a really incredible feeling when you do that, and he kind of went down this rabbit hole, and here we are 15 years later, and we've got about 40 farms between Cumbria and Cornwall growing for us, basically.
Now, most people, when they think about food and the environment, they wouldn't necessarily think that bread was a big issue, they would probably go straight to meat. But why is bread a big issue?
So it's really about, it's about how things are grown, and what farming system that bread's coming from, basically. So the bread that we're growing the bread that we're making is grown in a farming system that supports nature and it encourages biodiversity, it sorts out water retention, which avoids flooding, it gets a lot of nutrients into our body, and it makes sure that the soil is really healthy next year when you want to go and grow more. Most of the bread that we're eating, there's 12 million loaves a day are being sold in the UK, most of it is coming from a destructive farming system. And so we need to try and get as many of these 12 million loaves a day being grown in a system like wild farmed, and that way we can start reversing climate change.
Mm. And why did you specifically want to make this move from the entertainment industry to sustainable farming and agriculture?
I'd been a television presenter, I'd worked in entertainment for a long time, I started off in music, ended up being a TV presenter, it was all going pretty well, I was, commercially I was perceived to be a kind of success, but it wasn't really making my heart sing, and I felt like there was something missing, and I wanted to try and understand why I'm here, I guess is the question we all ask ourselves at some point in our lives. And I decided I didn't want to be a TV presenter anymore, and I sold all my house and all my stuff, and I went off on a kind of quest to figure out who I was. And halfway through that journey, I met Andy, and he told me what he was doing, and it just made sense. We've totally lost the connection with where food comes from, and we're all inevitably worried about the climate and worried about the environment, but it feels quite abstract. And I haven't been to Antarctica, and I don't spend a lot of time in the Amazon, and so it's difficult to feel a kind of connection with that, whereas every day the food that we're eating, hopefully three times a day, we've got an opportunity to shape the health of the planet. And so all of a sudden, my kind of like the anxiety I was having, Andy kind of made it tangible and kind of put it into this kind of bite-sized solution for me. And I was just like, right, maybe that's what we've got to do, and that's what we've got to focus on. And so I just told him I was, I was in and I was behind him. And that's, we've been kind of 7 years now, really, kind of gradually working on it. And the last two, we've all gone full time on it, and it's going great.
Well, in order to help the audience understand, what you've been talking about, there's also a documentary that's come out, and there will also be some posters that will go out across the capital with some QR codes.
Yep.
Can you tell us a bit about both those things?
Yeah, so we made a film called A Story About Bread, essentially, number one, it shows you that actually a real tangible solution to the climate problem we're facing could just be bread. Obviously there's been a lot of stuff going on up at COP, a lot of big ideas, a lot, again, as I say, abstract kind of stuff getting thrown around, but actually if we can just pull it back down to your everyday choices, so you don't have to stop eating pizza, just buy this pizza instead of that one, and you can be part of the solution. Most people don't want to glue themselves to the M25 or maybe not in a position where they can go and change their car and change the power in their house and this and and that and the other, but they can make small choices every day that will ultimately affect what kind of environment we're living in. And so, yeah, we've made a 7-minute documentary about that. You can check it out on our website. You can check it out on YouTube. And if you see, we've done these big toasts that you'll see around town if you live in London, which you will do because this is London Live. But yeah, we've got a QR code on there. If you hit the QR code, you'll go through to our website. You'll be in with a chance of winning free bread for a year if you sign up to our newsletter. And yeah, hopefully, I mean, it's been out for a day. We hit nearly 20,000 views. So yeah, hopefully we can get it out there and get as many people just to start thinking about like the little decisions that they're making, how big when you kind of compound them all together, how big an impact they can have.